Dear friends of Powershoots TV, positive energy in Europe. Today I'm again in the Audio-Visula studios in Brussels of the European Commission, and it's really my great pleasure and honor to welcome the Commissioner for Transport, Violeta Bulc. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
So, Commissioner for Transport, I know it is your world. It's also my world because we met so many times because we work on transport. And I think also citizens in Europe use transport every day. So we have transport, I would say, on the road. We have transport on rail, ship, and also the air. Please explain us a little bit what are you doing and how citizens in Europe benefit of your work, maybe from each sector a little bit, and how is the evaluation, how you say, in Europe at the moment?
Well, usually people pay attention to transport means when transport stops. And if transport stops, everything stops. So on EU level, we really try to make sure that European Union, all member states, really invest and develop all transport means in order for citizens to travel, to engage in different projects, to cooperate in business manner, but of course to visit relatives and friends. But on the other side, we also take care of that European businesses stay competitive. Logistic costs are one of the most important costs of every product shipped. So we want to make sure that that all the logistic services are available, affordable, competitive. So in nutshell, this is where we are, our focus is. But if I want to get into a little bit more detail, I would say that my first priority is to ensure connectivity, being within EU or across, so that every member state can take a full advantage of a single market. The second one is efficiency. As I prompted, I've said already before, efficiency for the citizen and for the businesses is a very important element, but not any kind of, so for the affordable price available to everyone. But the third one probably touches the hearts of citizens the most. Transport being part of the big development drive of any kind of civilization, actually, also created negative effects. So we're paying a lot of attention, especially within this commission, to really lower the negative effects of progress, meaning pollution, being air or noise, which is very disturbing as well. On the other hand, something that is the most emotional and affects so many families, way too many across EU, are road accidents and serious injuries. And of course, the third one, congestion. So these are our primary goals that we are after, to bring down negative externalities, to improve efficiency and to improve connectivity.
There's a little bit because I'm so positive about Europe. And then I said to myself, yes, traffic is raising on each side. So the problem will be bigger. And you have to fight harder and harder. But how can you be competitive against this big challenge?
Well, you're right. One of the status symbols of progress is to own your own car, to be able to move wherever you want. And we need to be very honest. In the past, let's say 20, 30 years, we forgot a little bit about the public transport, about multimodality, about really thinking to use the best possible mode to travel wherever we want to travel. And I was very strongly leading in this way. We promote different transport modes and we promote to use public transport and new ways that are now emerging, which is certainly the shared economy solution, shared cars, shared bikes, shared scooters, but at the same time to create these multimodal zones where citizens can easily switch from one mode to another. Here, the most important part, the cities will play. So the close cooperation with cities, encouragement that is coming from our side to work with member states very closely in planning these multimodal nodes, not only for the citizens, but also for businesses in a sense of transshipment centers.
And maybe around all these modes, maybe you have an example of the most positive thing happening, actually, where you can say, I'm proud, even with my team, you reached it. This is good for Europe. This is good for citizens. Do you have maybe anything?
I do. I do a lot of them, but let me focus just on a few. Unfortunately, they will not be seen tomorrow when citizens step out of their house. But in a couple of years' time, the real effect will be seen to all citizens. For example, we are this year in the process of replacing 14,000 local rules for railways with only 1,600 rules. This will be an enormous simplification of railways. And
you work already a long time on it this year.
Yes.
It's the rail package.
Exactly. It's the rail package 1, 2, 3, 4. And this huge change happens as a consequence of a well-negotiated fourth railway package from 2 years ago.
And how we feel this?
You will feel that the railways will run smoother, faster. There will be no stops at the borders in a sense of changing the front engine, changing the whole team. But the trains will be able to travel with much less interruptions, which means they will be faster, they will have less delays, and hopefully on the long run, they will really connect the entire EU. That we will see by 2030, because right now we are heavily investing in railways. That will not only help us to take a load of this public transport from point to point, but also they help us a lot in bringing the pollution down.
Okay, and when we see it, for example, with the ships, with the goods, how does it look
like?
Because a big question, there's always a big critic that the pollution of the container ships is...
Well, that's another thing. The huge agreement that everybody appreciates in maritime ecosystem is that we finally negotiated a single window for the European maritime area, which means that we will have a unified data transfer among all the ports. All ports will be digitally connected, and that will again speed up the procedures, lower the price, efficiency will go up for over 60%. Citizens will maybe not might not feel that directly that much, maybe through ferries or something like that, but the huge benefit is for businesses. At the same time, we negotiated historical deal on a global level. Maritime is a global business, like aviation. So all the pollution and decarbonization issues need to be addressed globally. And under this commission, both agreements have been reached. And this is so historical.
And
the citizens will feel that, again, eventually, because it's going to be less pollution, it's going to be less noise. But that doesn't come by itself. The core for solving the challenges that are really disturbing to citizens, noise, pollution, air pollution, will come also through new technologies. And that's another thing that EU Commission already in this period has devoted a lot of investment in new products, in new propulsion systems, in new materials, in order to improve the, or let's say, decrease the negative consequences. And we will see in the next financial period, 21-27, that over 70% of investments in transport will be towards less pollution and emissions. And I think that
in the entire EU, on
all modes.
Yeah.
So we're walking the path. We are very dedicated. I believe that climate change needs to be addressed. I believe that the quality of life needs to be addressed. And I'm really glad I was able to lead also all my colleagues and the entire ecosystem in making commitments for Vision Zero by 2050.
Yeah.
In pollution, Vision Zero. In road accidents, we have clear Vision Zero. It is unacceptable that in today, 21st century, we have so many fatalities on European roads. 25,000 and over 136,000 are seriously injured.
Yeah.
It doesn't help that we are the best in the world. Yeah, we do have the best safety record, but this is unacceptable. Yeah. So through technology, autonomous mobility, through system approach, meaning better control on the roads, better investments in infrastructure, through change of the behavior. But again, technology will play an important role to automated and autonomous technology. So this is realistic. So I'm so excited about that.
See, I have so many questions and I have to change the subject because you're too much in it. And, you can talk for hours, but let's change a little bit. Past, present, future.
Yes.
In your opinion, how looks the future of Europe? We had the elections.
Yes.
So are the elections, you think, good for Europe, bad for Europe? How does the future in general look? So how do you see all this in the transport world compared to the transport for sure, and also private for sure?
Yeah. Look, first of all, I would like to invite everyone that we can really be very proud on EU as a project. It's a peace project. It has never happened in the history of this continent to have peace for so many years in a row. And I do believe that this can be achieved in the future as well. And I don't think that there is a bigger value than peace, because when we have peace, we can be really free, we can engage, we can exercise. But that doesn't mean that everything has been achieved. And the messages that citizens were passing in the last couple of years, being detached from the leadership of European Union, not knowing exactly how to involve, where to involve in these processes, they've been hurt. And I personally try to address them as much as possible through citizens' dialogues, to really listening to everyone who has good ideas how to improve transport portfolio. And I do believe that this will be one of the major tasks for the next commission as well, in order to continue with this really direct engagement, participatory models, to bring citizens at the core of the decision-making. But let's be honest, these elections, there was a clearly one big winner, and that was EU. EU won.
After all, yes.
And another good impulse, which I'm very grateful to the citizens for, is that the two groups that gained most were the Greens and the Liberals. And that gives a fresh spirit. It brings many new fresh ideas. And I believe that the new leadership of EU will be well balanced. I'm quite convinced that we will have, for the first time, serious presence of women leaders as well.
Yeah, that's what I saw in
the Yes. Yeah. And another thing I'm glad is that I participated in Team Europe, and we proved that teamwork always wins over an individual. So this should be a spirit of EU over and over again repeated, that only together, only with a clear support, participation, but still keeping our own individuality, we can win.
Yeah, I think even the people from the right side are ready to discuss.
Yes.
So it's quite interesting. But as you said, I think everybody believes in Europe. Yes, we saw that, and we don't talk about the other side, the Brexit and so on. We're going to see. But very last question, not to the commissioner, but to the citizen Violeta. What do you still want to achieve in your life, private or in politics, whatever, just short?
Well, I love the job that I have, and that job just reinforced my capacity to serve. I just love working with people, and this has been basically the story all my life. So I will definitely continue to engage, who knows where. We don't know exactly yet on where and how. This is my first priority. The second priority is I really would like to support my two kids, that they can fully develop their potentials and that they can really enjoy life and contribute to this incredible civilization the way how I did. So that's my very strong commitment. I'd like to travel to space.
Okay.
That is my really deep, deep unfulfilled wish. But the way how things are developing, I think in my lifetime, I will achieve that as well. But then continue to engage, continue to engage with my friends, with my family, with all who want to create a better world. I am the one who really loves life.
Yeah,
I love this planet Earth, really. I love Europe and I love Slovenia, which is the country where I'm originally from. So in all this diversity of big and small, there is so much room for creation and so much room for cooperation. So that's where I will be looking for my next opportunity.
No, really. Thank you very much, Commissioner, for your positive energy for Europe and the citizens. Even you outside, thanks for listening. Really, I've followed her for 4 years now because I work a lot on transport, and she is really somebody, a real citizen, getting commissioner and believing in Europe, and she knows also the side of the citizen. So she has really easy to have a real dialogue. Thanks, everybody, for listening. And as I said always, what you give to other people, you get back. So stay positive, believe in what you are doing, believe in Europe, and share this positive message. Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.